So in this lecture, we will be discussing the judicious use of articles. You know, we know very well what are the articles, a, an, and the. These are the three articles, indefinite articles and definite articles. There are two types of articles. We naturally use without any mistake about the indefinite articles. When we are using the indefinite articles, we use them very comfortably and most of the times without any error about the a and an. But we carelessly use the articles, that is the definite article the, and this is the point where we lose the coherence, or you can say cohesion, in the language. We will discuss this thing also, what are the cohesion and coherence in our next module. But indefinite article, what does it mean? Indefinite articles, a is used before a singular noun beginning with a consonant, while an is used before a singular noun beginning with a vowel sound. So, but the definite article the, where it is used, it must be taken care of. I will just recall the places where it should be used. However, you know it very well. I'm just recalling them so that you must recall them for your academic writing purposes. Okay? First one, the is used before a singular or plural noun. It is used to denote a specific thing or a particular member of a group. Say, for example, the formulation one showed better activity. So we are writing about that particular formulation. It is a definite formulation about we are talking about. That's why it is the definite article. Okay? So we are mentioning about that particular formulation. That's why we use the. Next thing is, before the superlatives, we use the highest, the most, the largest, the highest. So with the superlative degree, we use, before that we use the. Before the geographical areas and places like the US, the Europe, the Taj Mahal, or before the natural things, the sun, the moon, the stars, the Himalaya, the Ganges. So use the before the natural thing. Before a noun which has been mentioned earlier, for example, a particle was observed in the test tube. It is the first sentence, okay? Second sentence, the particle was removed from the test tube. Which particle? Which has been addressed. Which particle we are talking about? The second sentence, which has been discussed in the previous sentence. So, the is mentioning about the previous particle which has been addressed in the sentence one. So, for referring to a noun which has been addressed in the previous sentence, we put the. So, dear learners, what is the key message? Unnecessary and inappropriate use of articles may be very awkward in academic writing and may also lead to the rejections of your manuscript, your hard work. It will all go in vain if you use the articles inappropriately or unnecessarily. So, be vigilant when you are using the articles. Now, let's talk about the punctuation errors. How we can improve, how we can use effectively punctuation, and how we can identify the punctuation errors. It is very, very important. You know? Many times, reviewers give a big question mark on a large number of punctuation errors in your manuscript. So, as you know, punctuation errors are the most common errors in the manuscript. It is also the most common cause of rejection of an article in initial phase. So, while drafting a manuscript, we are almost busy with the technical issues and the scientific issues of the articles. And when we are in final stages, we are in a hurry to submit. So, most of the time, we skip the things like simple things like punctuation. But, you know, the inappropriate use of punctuation may lose the meaning, may alter the meaning, may deviate the meaning. So, you will have to be very, very cautious when you are using the punctuation. So, we focus very much on the technical issues, but we ignore the punctuation errors. We ignore these errors. So, what happens? Many times, what the editor does, when you have submitted the manuscript, editor sent it back to you. Rather than sending it to the reviewer, because he has seen that, you know, you have done this, a lot many punctuation errors. So, your articles won't go to the reviewing phase even. Before that, editors himself make an observation and send it back to you. That improve this with terms in terms of punctuation errors. So, you will have to focus on these punctuation errors before final submission. Among the various punctuation marks, we are generally comfortable in the use of full stop, question mark, exclamation mark, apostrophe. Mistakes occur in our use of comma, hyphen, colon, semicolon. Please refer the very simple and effective text from the free e-content available on the website of Commonwealth of Learning. It is www.col.org. You can refer the things that how the commas are used, that two or commas are used for separating the following, like two or more adjectives describing one noun, individual items in a list, a parenthesis, the name of the person addressed, and sentence adverbs. This you can see in the OER 4 English second language module of the Commonwealth of Learning. So what is the tip? What is the final tip for using the punctuation effectively and avoiding the punctuation errors? Number one, use comma after sentence adverb like so, therefore, however, consequently, thereupon, for example, for instance, otherwise, nevertheless, perhaps, after all, in the meantime, indeed, moreover, and so on. So, you must know, most of the time you are using therefore, moreover, so don't forget putting the comma after them. Next tip, check the brackets for the completeness. Never skip the closing bracket. Never skip the closing bracket. Otherwise, they will get mingled with each other. Okay? So, never place any punctuation before the parenthesis. For example, look at this sentence. The results were in the agreement to the previous study. Here you have and with the official limits. So here, before this 10 in between the brackets, the comma is inappropriate. You must avoid it. Now next thing is, quote the words or sentences you have copied. Underquote the effect of, you know, whatever the word you have copied or what is the quotation, it must be under the quote. Do not rely on the spell checker for use of hyphen in scientific writing or academic writing. Technically, it should be convincing. For example, anti-diabetic is okay, while the spell checker suggests it to be anti-diabetic. So, write anti-diabetic, which is more comfortable and which is more common and more natural in academic writing. However, grammatically, the Microsoft Grammar Checker, spell checker may give it anti-diabetic. So write it without that hyphen, okay? Spell checker or auto-correction must not be relied on completely. The spelling of word may be right, but it may be totally irrelevant for your context. You know, the spelling will be okay, but it will be completely out of your context. Say for example, the patient was given the doses. Here the patient was required. Patience is also okay. Patient is also okay. But spell checker gave you, in place of patient, gave you the patience. However, it is wrong with respect to the context. Another example. The manager ordered the executives to complete the task. Manager, not the manager. Manger and manager, both are spelling is good, but it is out of context. So, dear learners, in this module, we learn the importance of English in academic writing. What are the basic rules of effective English in academic writing? And what are the problems faced by the non-native speakers? And what are the solutions for avoiding those problems or for solving those problems? Let me summarize what we have learned so far. You know, English is required. English is utmost essential for communicating with the global fraternity of researchers. Let's summarize some key points. Use formal language. Keep it simple. Keep it concise. Keep it unambiguous. Do not rely on spell checker. Effectively use active and passive voice and the articles. Avoid the grammatical errors. See whether the subject agrees with the verb. And avoid the punctuation errors. So, dear learners, these are some very basic keys which we learned in this module. By learning these things, we can improve our English in academic writing. In our next module, we will be discussing what is required for improving your academic writing in English. We will be discussing the cohesion and coherence, which are utmost essential elements of effective academic writing.